So let's read the question first. The question is, write a JavaScript program which is event driven. On click event, we'll calculate the factorial of a number. Now let's go ahead. You are now ready to start with how to write a script. As you are usually now known that you must start your code with HTML, because JavaScript comes as an insertion into an HTML script. Thereafter I am writing head, and here I am going to write the whole code with a function factorial, or I can say fact, FAC, here into the JavaScript, into the head section. So I'll be writing a form, putting a button, clicking that button, it should invoke the function which is meant for factorial. So I started my JavaScript, writing script language is equal to JavaScript. I started opening braces of my function. Then I wrote here function name first. Say function name is fact. Factorial, it is fact, FAC. Again the starting braces. And here I am going to declare a variable which is a counter variable for a loop. And this variable is known as I. Now I am going to accumulate the multiplication. So I can't initialize the variable fact, which is a variable which will accumulate the multiplication as 0, because anything multiplied by 0 will be always what? 0. And if you do not initialize this variable, may it contain a garbage value and the multiplication goes wrong. The programmer has to take care. But then what happens if I initialize it at one, with 1? So I am right now, you are initializing this fact as equal to 1. Let's see the beauty of initializing this as 1. Let's go ahead. I am going to take input from a user which contains a document object with the form name P. The variable field name, which is going to be the container to hold the value, is num, and its value is, I am going to get an extracted as an integer and stored into a variable called x. Why I have to extract it? Because I can't do any calculation. When a number is added with a space, it is treated as a character. So parse int function will remove all the spaces which are there into the text box which has come along with the input, and it will give you purely integer, and it is storing into the variable x. That's how you are going to find out, and you are going to take from the user the value of x. Now you have got the inputted value, which fact, whose factorial has to be found out. Let's go ahead. Here I will start my loop, but see, while writing the loop in a reverse order, I should start with the number which the user has inputted. So my loop starts with a statement for I is equal to x. So loop is initialized. If my inputted value is 5, then I should start with 5 in place of x. Thereafter semicolon, and I am going to test a condition here that this loop will run until 1 comes. Okay, and thereafter every time the I's value should be deducted by 1. So I have written a notation I minus minus. So when you write a for statement, the first parameter is the initial value, the second parameter is your condition, and the third parameter here is your either incrementation or decrementation. Now dear students, here the value could be 5 and the loop will run up till 1. So every time the value should be reduced. Take care, this is a very important line when you go for a factorial. There is also another way. You can start your loop from 1 and go to the final value by incrementing also, or you can go with the concept that you will start with the value which is final value, go on decrementing here in a loop every time by 1, because a small notation I minus minus will be treated as I is equal to I minus 1. So every time I's value, if it is 5, then next time it will be 4, then next time it will be 3, then next time it will be 2, and last time it will be 1. As soon as the value reaches to 1, that is equal to, the loop should stop. So let's go to the next statement. I am putting it into the braces over here. Here I am accumulating the multiplication which is done by the variable. So what I am doing here, fact is equal to fact into I. Let us understand, the initial value of fact was 1. Why I said there is a beauty? Because here the computer substitutes 1, and there with I it substitutes what? If you are entered 5, it will substitute 5, and 5 into 1 is multiplied here and will be stored in a memory location FACT as 5. Next time the loop iterates and it goes up, its value will be reduced from 5 to 4. Again, the condition is not satisfied, that means I is still greater than 1. It will enter into the loop, and now the current value of fact is what? 5. It will be multiplied by with 4, and so forth. This loop will go on running every now and then till it reaches 1. Once it reaches 1, the entire accumulation of multiplication is put into the variable called fact, and thereafter I can say here document.write factorial of number is, and I can display the fact value. Dear students, the program is almost all over here. It is a very small program. I hope you have understood this program. I will close the brace of the function. My first job of writing a function is over, my dear students, but still there is something which is pending, which I should conclude also. My script is not closed yet, so I should close the script braces. Thereafter, I should close my script tag. Thereafter, I should close my head, because the entire JavaScript was written into the head section. Now, dear students, we must write a code for form, because I must accept the value for the factorial. Fine. Now, I have written your body. I have designed and I designated the form name as p, as I have explained you earlier into the function. Thereafter, I have entered here. I am saying enter a number to find a factorial, and there should be a text box given for a user. So I am writing a code here in HTML, input type equal to text, name is equal to num, the variable name of the number is num, and the size of the text box is, I have written 20. Thereafter, I am putting a br over here. Thereafter, I am putting a button here. Input type equal to button, and I am writing on a face as find factorial on the face of that button. And on click, I am going to call a function which is known as fact. So here, once I called a function on a fact, the control will be transferred into the head section. It will execute the factorial, and now I am putting br for a documentation, leave a blank space. Close my form, close my body of the code, HTML tag closes the whole HTML script. Dear students, now let's have a look that you have seen this code. Here there is a code to calculate a factorial which is written into the head section. It is an internal JavaScript, and thereafter I have written the whole code onto a button object and on a click event. Maybe some other time you will be asked to write a program on mouse over event of a button. So where the entire program remains same, only the value over here on click should be written as what? On mouse over, where on should be small, M should be capital, and OUSE should be small, and O should be capital, and OVR other characters are small. It is a case sensitive language. You should take care while you write your event names. The same program can be written in two different ways. I will talk to you later as a separate program how you can write these programs onto the mouse over event, and I hope you will be able to conclude. Now let us go back. Let us execute the code which is there for a factorial. Let's go and find out. This is the program which will work on a click. Let's see the code into the notepad, ensure ourselves. Now you are able to see the code. It is as it is. I have shown you into the presentation. I have written here the function I, and fact is initialized to 1 because I can't initialize it to 0. I can't lead it to store a garbage value. Thereafter, I am writing a loop, and this is a loop which is a specialized loop for decrementing the value. The initial value will be bigger, and the loop will run up till 1 it reaches, and every time the value of the loop is deducted, or the index of the loop is deducted by 1. Thereafter, the factorial is an accumulation of multiplication. First time it is implemented and it is multiplied by 1, and later on till 1 it is going on accumulating into the variable which is known as fact. Thereafter, document.write, we will be displaying the output, and in document.write the variable will give you the value which is finally accumulated into the multiplication. Here there is a form, form name is p. Here there is a text box, and this text box has got size of 20. There is a button, and this button when you click will call this function factorial from the head section. Calculate the entire thing and will display you the output. I hope now you are clear how the program can be written with a click event, and I hope it could help you a greater help into your exam. I wish you best of luck. Let's go and execute this program and see the final outcome and the result. I'm executing the program. I'm writing the factorial for 3. It should be what? 3 into 2 into 1. That means 3 into 2 is 6. Multiply by 1 is again 6. Find the factorial when I click. The answer is 6. You can put any number over here. Suppose if I put a number 5 over here, what should be the factorial? It should be 120. I hope so. Now you are clear with the concept. Wish you best of luck for your exams. I hope you will be now very clear how to write a code in JavaScript. Thank you very much.